Mr. True. Okay, so thanks for joining me again. I hope these videos are helping. In AP statistics right now, we're talking about, we're going to just start tinkering into the looking at relationships between categorical variables. Now, actually testing whether or not two categorical variables are related or has a strong relationship, that requires something called a chi-square test and a chi-square goodness of fit test. We're very far away from that. So we're just going to be looking at some two-way tables, finding some row and column percents, and just sort of discussing what patterns we see in the numbers. So what I've done is I pulled some information off the internet, which I'll summarize for you at the end of the video, and kind of use it to make up this two-way table, studying the relationship between education levels and how much people are getting paid. So we got no high school, and college. I've got some pay scales broken down by category. Now, pay is money. Money can be averaged. You might think that that's a quantitative variable, but when you break it into categories of income, well, now it's no longer quantitative, but categorical. Okay. Now, on the outside of this table of incomes, four rows and three columns, we have what's called a marginal distribution. That's where I've just added up all the totals. So if you add up all these people that supposedly have interviewed that did not have a high school diploma, there's 97 of them. You add up all the high schools, that's 315. Totals going in the rows as well. And ultimately, we have 591 people in this supposed survey that we're studying. All right. What we're going to do is ask, is there a relationship between those two? Hopefully, if we're in college and taking honor classes, we're hoping that, of course, there is. While you can analyze the counts, percents are easier and may have a choice. You may have a choice in how to set up those percents, but usually it'll be dictated to you in the problem based on the variables or the language of the questions. Now, why would we not want to just look at this table of counts and go, well, clearly, the more school you have, the more you make? And we probably can, but these totals are not equal. So we might feel like there's something going on there that there really isn't, simply because we're looking at these numbers, but we're missing the fact that, oh, this is 153 out of 315. And while this is a lower number, it's also out of a much smaller group. So we always want to use relative frequencies or percents when doing comparisons, much like why we prefer relative frequency histograms to just regular frequency histograms when comparing two distributions. Okay, now on the computer, on the camera, we cannot show you the table and these questions at the same time, so refer back to them or maybe go back and copy that table for a minute as I talk about these questions. Okay, so we have the question of simply, out of all the people I looked at, what percent have a college education? Well, that turned out that would be a margin percent. Those were the totals at the bottom, and it was 97 out of 591, which is going to be 16.4%. Okay, well, now all of these questions, the two white ones and the two yellow ones, are conditional probabilities. And conditional probabilities will come back in symbol format when we talk about probability rules in a later chapter. But I would bet that reading these, you probably would have set these up correctly already. What percent of college grads make $40,000 to $65,000? Well, that is the number, first of all, the condition is what is the percent of college grads. So we're not using everybody in the study, that was 591 people. We're only considering the people that graduated from college, and that was a total of 179. Sorry about that. So, or this is the same question, given that you are a college educated person, what is the probability you make between 40 and 65,000? Again, that's 71 over 179. So these two questions are both giving you, they're looking for the same fractional answer or the same percent, 71 over 179, but the second one is more blatantly telling you what the condition is. I don't want to know all the people, I don't want to talk about all the people that make between $40,000 and $65,000. I want to just talk about those that graduated from college. So the 179 as opposed to the 519. So you need to read these questions, you need to identify occasionally, especially when they're talking about two variables in the same question, they're probably giving you a condition, and that is going to dictate whether you do a row or column percent. The college grad, given that you're a college grad, what percent of college grads? Well, if you go back and you look at the previous part of the video, the college was in the top of the column. So again, this 79 divided by 179, these are column percents because this variable is the top of the column. So what about what percent of those making $40,000 to $65,000 went to college? Or more obviously, given that you make $45,000 to $65,000, what is the probability you got a college diploma? Well, those are both the same question, worded a little bit differently. And you know, with English, there's all kinds of ways to move these words around a little bit, and it can occasionally be a little bit tricky to determine which one is the condition and which one is the you know, to set up the bottom of the fraction. So what percent of those making $40,000 to $65,000? Well, $40,000 to $65,000 was on the side of the table we just had up there a second ago on that blackboard. So that is going to be a row percent. How many people make $40,000 to $65,000? Well, out of our survey, it was 177. So then out of that group, how many went to college? 71. So 71 divided by 177 will be the percent of people making $40,000 to $65,000 that went to college. If you wanted just the percent of people that made $40,000 to $65,000, period, with no condition, it would be 177 divided by 519. But these are all examples of conditional probabilities. You must be a college grad to be considered. You must make $40,000 to $65,000 to be considered in these percents. The margin distributions do not have any condition given. So to describe a relationship among categorical variables, calculate the appropriate percent based on the condition. That's what I'm talking about. Column percent, or in this second example, row percent from the counts. Okay, so that's how you set up conditional probabilities or marginal distribution, non-conditional probabilities, out of a two-way table.
No.
So what you would want to do then for comparison purposes is, I have gone through what's the distribution of income among the three levels of education. So I've worded this as, and we would think, education would help explain how much you make. So if the if your education is helping to explain how much you make, then that condition, that variable needs to be how you set up the percent. So these are all going to be column percents. 62 with no high school making 0 to 25,000 out of the total of 97 non-high school grad students. This 48.6% comes from 153 divided by 315, the number of people making 25 to 40,000 and having a high school diploma, given that they have a high school diploma. So these are all column percents, and I can now look at it and go, well, for non-high school students, of course, you have a much lower income bracket. For college students, or for college grads, your higher percents are in your higher income brackets of 25 to 40,000, 40 to 65, and 65 or more. And if you want more than just looking at a table of percents, and again, those column percents will make it nice and easy for us to analyze, or at least hypothesize that there's a relationship between education and income level. To really prove there's a relationship will require, again, a chi-square test, and we are not going to do that for many, many months. You can take these percents and create some bar graphs. Remember, bar graphs and pie charts are our two categorical graphs that we'll be dealing with. Please do not talk about things like left-right skewed or normal or symmetric. Those are all language vocab words for quantitative data. This is all set up in bar graph form. This is all categorical data, so do not use language you use for dot plots, stem plots, histograms. You can just discuss, look, non-high school graduates or non-high school graduates for making $0 to $25,000 is much higher than the high school and college grad individuals. For incomes of $40,000 to $65,000, I can compare non-high school, high school, and college grads. So see what I've made here is a bar graph out of this first row of data and a bar graph out of the third row of data. I couldn't really display all of this in a single bar graph unless it was a bunch of side-by-side bar graphs. And even then it would be confusing, so just better to have it separate like this. And to conclude the video, before I do Simpson's Paradox, which is next, that'll be a second video, I've got a link on the top of this video for you to look at or just easily go to. I made up these numbers, but I did go to the internet and I did find a website that talked about degree and how much people made. And so you can clearly see that the higher education is, the higher the median income is. Now, why do you think on the internet they reported the median income for those education levels? Well, income, if not broken down by category, like 0 to 25,000, income as a quantitative variable is going to be right skewed. A lot of people make very little money, and a few at the top, the stars of the football team or the CEOs of the companies make a tremendous amount of money. So money is always going to be right skewed. So they would not want to report the, well, I guess you could, but it'd be a little misleading to report the average incomes because all of these variables, if the income is used as a quantitative value, is going to be right skewed, and the mean is always pulled closest to the tail because it's not resistant. The median is.
Woo!
All right. Thank you very much.